factor in leadership. And they also say they stand by her record of advocacy. Anderson?
All right, Paul Verkammen, thank you. A lot to talk about with our panel. Joining me tonight to the program, CNN political commentator, Huffington Post live host, Marc Lamont Hill, also cultural critic and writer, Michaela Angela Davis. So, Mark, what do you make of this? I mean, she got apparently a complete scholarship to Howard University, a very prestigious African-American college, and I don't know if she, I don't believe she said, I don't think on the application for that it has race marked off, but I guess on this application for this police tribunal, she did indicate that she's African-American.
Absolutely, and again, I'm puzzled by this, Anderson. People historically have lied about their race in order to get more stuff, right? They've lied in order to avoid Jim Crow. They've lied in order to get access to jobs. They've lied in order to be safe from lynching. Very few people choose black as an identity unless they have to. Black is something people have historically tried to get out of, which is also problematic. So this is a puzzling choice for this woman. On some level, it speaks to the way that we think about race right now, which is that it's an individual choice, that it's a social construct, all this fluid stuff. But on the other hand, I think it speaks to a very dangerous practice of trying on someone's identity, of trying on a marginalized notion of race whenever you want to. To me, it's the ultimate exercise in white privilege to say, I'm going to be black for a little while.
Yeah, Michaela, that's an interesting point. I mean, can you try on, can you just say, oh, I'm black? I mean, if I just started to say I'm black, I don't think a lot of people would believe me. But two, I mean, is there something offensive about that?
Well,
because you
haven't
lived through the same experience as somebody who can't change their ethnicity.
Well, just for the record, you know, black people love you, Anderson, but this is like appropriation to a pathological level, right? If it weren't real, it reads like a Chappelle show skit because of all the nuances that she's bringing to it. And what it does is it triggers people's pain. Like, history does matter. So it does, because I think that she has some kind of mental disorder because of the degree in which she has, you know, created family members and probably created this hate mail story. So I think we're looking at an individual with some kind of racial or identity disorder, some kind of dysmorphia. But what it is doing, it is triggering the work of real black women whose lives are threatened all the time. Where she can, if she decides to take that weave out, she can go about her life and be a white woman. You know, she doesn't struggle with edges. Like, I saw her give a lecture on black hair and privilege, and she was claiming it as hers. And what's so disturbing is she could have done all this good work as a white woman, right? She could have actually used her white privilege to help this civil rights movement. There have been white people in resistance and going against structural racism all the time. She didn't need to lie in order to do good race work. So right. That's why I think there's something going on with her family. Like, this is weird.
Mark, it's interesting what Michaela is just saying, because the NAACP in their statement were saying, look, you know, it doesn't matter, you know, there's plenty of white people in the NAACP, and certainly throughout the history of the civil rights movement, there have been white people who have joined along in that. But it's one thing to say I'm a white person and I'm in the NAACP. It's another thing to say as a Caucasian person, I'm black and I'm in the NAACP. I mean, why not just say, well, I was born white, but these are my beliefs.
Because let me again preface this by saying I think there are some mental health issues here, and so I don't want to completely make this an issue of her character. She may not be willfully making any of these choices at the level that we might be attaching to her, but I think there is again an exercise of white privilege here to be able to say I know what's best for black people. So if you're a white woman, yeah, you can still be a part of the NAACP. The NAACP, all the way back to the Niagara Movement, folks like John Dewey have been at the center of NAACP. White folks started the NAACP on a lot of levels. So it's not a question of that. The question is, what does it mean for black people to choose their own leadership? Maybe they would not have elected her to be the leader of the NAACP if she were a white woman. They may have made a different choice. Maybe the university that she works at, perhaps they would not have hired her if they knew they were hiring a white woman to teach Africana studies. Not because white people can't teach Africana studies, but perhaps they had a diversity hire and they wanted to hire someone of color to diversify an increasingly white university. These are choices that black people can make, and if you're an advocate of black people, you should be advocating black self-determination, the opportunity and ability of us to make our own choices for ourselves. We can't do that if you throw on the braids and the sarongs and act as if you are African and blacker than black. Mm-hmm. And look, I don't know her well, but I have been in settings with her. I have organized with her. I've been on the West Coast and talked with her. And one of the things that she's been adamant about, and other activists will attest to this, just with regard to the Black Lives Matter movement, she was one of the people that said the Black Lives Matter movement needs to be led and directed by black people. Outsiders should not be there. It's the height of arrogance to say that at the and mendacity to say that at the very same time that you're actually white in the middle of it. She's out there tweeting about Tyrese, you know.
She announced that she was going to go natural. She announced on her birthday that she was going to go natural. Like, it's so complex. Yeah. It's so complex.
It is complex.
Layered in pathology.
Yeah, it was interesting because in Sky News she just did an interview, a second interview today, and she said, you know, I can't really explain it to a lot of people because they're just not going to understand it. I would love to have a conversation with her just to try to understand where she's coming from, how she sees this, because I do think she has some explanation in her mind. I would be genuinely interested in hearing that. We certainly invite her, obviously, on the program. Marc Lamont Hill, good to have you on. Michaela Angela Davis, always great to have you on.